Hello, fam. Oh my God, I'm so excited. My name is Magdalene Janet. If you are new, welcome to the family. Please don't forget to subscribe because we're always here hanging out, reviewing makeup and having a good time. And of course, welcome back to all my oldies but goodies. So guys, I'm so excited because e.l.f. just released their brow lift and I also bought the spatula and spoolie. So, oh, let's test it out. Of course, we are gonna start off with cleaning off the brows from the moisturizer, sunscreen, all that stuff that I placed. And as you can see, my brows are very sparse. They go down. They just need help. I like to have the lifted look because it just gives your face a lifted look and it opens your face. All right, so let's open her up. And of course, we all know what this reminds us of, the ABH Brow Wax. So let's see. Here we are. Ooh-wee. Here is the spoolie, regular spoolie, they have this, and then look, ooh, nice, nice, nice. Actually, it like melted. You see that right here? Yeah, right there, but it's cool. Now that we've cleaned up the brows, let's comb them up, see what we're working with. All right, so let's grab a little bit. It feels very jelly-like. Kind of moisturizing, you see it has that little sheen right there. So what we'll want to do is grab the product in our spoolie, saturate the spoolie with product so it sticks onto the brows. So what I'm gonna do is like really work this up, kind of putting a good amount of pressure so your brow hairs go up, because since my brows naturally go down, you really have to put some good pressure so they can stay up because they're stubborn. It actually feels very tacky. It has like a, not very, it has a good tacky feel to it. So I'm gonna continue doing this until I like what I see here. All right, this is the before and after. We're gonna let this dry a little bit just to see how it dries down. I'm just getting a Q-tip with some micellar water to remove whatever's on there. And it doesn't dry down because it is a wax, but I just wanted to see. The brows kind of came down a little bit, kind of scooping them back up. Going in with my NYX brow pen in the shade Ash Brown, I'm gonna start flicking the pen up. I'm gonna put the pressure right here on my pinky so I can have a light hand. You can just kind of go with how the hairs are shaped. So here we are. It gives us a very, very natural look. So what I'm going to do is add this brow, give you all the information about the product, and I'll be back. The new e.l.f. Brow Lift retails for $6. This is an extreme hold clear eyebrow shaping wax that holds your brows in place for a fluffy, feathered look. It's extreme long-lasting, holds lift, tames, sculpts brows for a feather-like effect with a clear universal finish. Easy, mess-free application. Conditioning formula nourishes brow hair. All e.l.f. products are cruelty-free and vegan. So now that we have both brows on, I like this brow better. You see how much higher it just goes versus this one. So let's try to get it to that point. It does feel waxy. It doesn't dry down like the Got To Be glue I usually use does, but we know that because we're working with the wax versus the actual glue that literally dries down. Now that we have the brows good going, we're gonna clean them up with this concealer. It's the Dermablend Concealer in 23 Neutral. It's a lighter shade because I like the brows to have a nice highlighted effect there. We're gonna lean back and just go exactly where the brow hairs are, where there's no product. Getting this brush and just blending that area out. You see how clean it looks versus this one. So now that both brows are on and cleaned up, it is currently 10:30. And you know what? I just realized I forgot to use the spatula. So let's use it. This usually flattens the brows down. So let's do that and see if this one, oh yeah, it's going up. And what I'm doing is using the flat side, pressing and pulling up, pressing and pulling up. And then here we can Brush them up. Oh, I kind of like that we can do this with product on and it's not smearing. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Now you can see more sparse areas. So let's get them. All right, here we go. This is how it's looking. I'll be back. All right, fam, here we are, brows on and everything. What do you think? How do you think they look? I wanna show you guys here a before and after. I really liked how this worked. I think it did what it's supposed to do. It's giving us the feathery look, a very natural-esque look. The only thing I will say, it is a very, very waxy product. And going with my pen over the hairs and the wax, it was a little bit difficult because it is waxy. Since we don't have a lot of hair here and my brow hairs are sparse, the wax can easily take over that area. So you have to go in with a very small amount if you have brows that are very light and fine, because it can easily overtake the brows and then you'll have a harder time filling them in. But other than that, I think it does what it's supposed to do for $6. But I'm gonna do an all day wear test so you guys can see how the brows look, if they continue like this or they fall flat. I do have oily skin and oil and moisture throughout the day just make me look a little bit gastada, you know? So let's jump in front of the window so you guys can see how they look and see you later, bye. All right, fam, really quick, brows. Daylight just gives us the truth. Look how natural it looks. It looks like I woke up like this. Not really, but you know what I mean? So not bad. Okay, I think I like it better. It is still waxy though. Not bad, huh? Hello, hello, it is almost 8:30. We've had the brows on for about 10 hours, you guys, look. But I did wanna show you guys in daylight how the brows were looking at around 3 o'clock. So it was a few hours when I did my first check-in. They're looking pretty good, pretty well put together, very, very natural. Here we are now. I'm so pleasantly surprised how well these brows look. Look how natural they look. Let me turn the lights down so you can see. They're not structured. That's what waxes usually do. You see, you have some hairs that will come down and it just gives you more of a natural feathery look as opposed to my got to be glue. That glue just shuts it down, it like sticks it onto your face and your brows won't move. With this e.l.f. Brow Lift Wax, it gives your brows a little bit of movement, but it also keeps them still. Does it keep them still and does it freeze them? I don't think so, because you can tell how this one has moved. I haven't really touched my face, so this kind of just came down because, like I told you guys, my brows really do come down. So that's why we're always trying to get them up. For $6 and it pretty much being a dupe for the AB8 Brow Freeze, I think it worked very, very well. What I really liked was this applicator. I love how flat this is. You see how flat it is? And then the spoolie, it's little. So it's specially designed for you to get a little bit and really work the product in every little piece of your brow, which is what I appreciate about this spoolie. I forgot to tell you guys, this one retails for $4. The brow wax is currently sold out on e.l.f.'s website, but I did read that it is an Ulta exclusive. So it will be at Ulta eventually. So I'll keep you guys updated in the description box. I'll link everything down in the description if you are looking for this, but this is definitely a good product. I'm just pleasantly surprised that we don't look gastada and the brows are right here, you know? They haven't rubbed off. But this is it, fam. Thank you so much for hanging out with me and spending a little bit of your day with me. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, click the button right there, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.